Please may come in, sir. Good morning, sir. Thank you, sir.
Mr. Abhinav Tyagi.
Right, sir.
You are coming from Agra.
Yes, sir.
Agra is in UP, is it? It is Uttar Pradesh.
Right, sir.
What was the old name for Uttar Pradesh?
Sir, Uttar Pradesh was formerly called Northern Province.
No.
So United, after that was also renamed as United Province.
Just before it was renamed as Uttar Pradesh, what was the name?
Sir, United Province.
Of?
Sorry sir, I'm not
United
aware.
United Provinces of Agra and Awadh.
Okay. Thank you,
so
sir.
Why it was known as United Provinces of Agra and Awadh?
Sir, Agra and Awadh were historically politically important centers in UP. Agra being the capital of Delhi Sultanate and then Mughals, and Awadh being agricultural hub. So I think
was,
that
was Awadh also a state with a ruler earlier. Your history, you took history also.
Yes, sir.
The subjects.
Yes, sir. Awadh was also a separate state which it had as ruler under the Mughals and Delhi Sultanate. It was governed by one of their important governors.
What was the capital of Awadh?
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware.
You know, some region is still known as Awadh. Which is that region which is known as Awadh in UP? Which is the region?
Sir, as far as I know, it's a region in the eastern of UP, but exactly where it is, I'm not aware.
You are aware of different languages which are spoken in UP?
Right, sir.
There is one language called Awadhiya also.
Yes, sir.
The language in Agra, is it Awadhiya or different?
No, sir, it is Braj Bhasha.
Braj Bhasha? Yes. Part of Braj?
Sorry, sir?
Is it part of Braj?
Yes, sir, Agra is a part of Braj.
I see. Otherwise, which is the main area that is known as Braj area?
Sir, the area around Mathura.
What is famous for?
So it is famous as a kingdom of Lord Krishna. Mm-hmm. It is said that Lord Krishna was born there and he was also raised up.
Have you been to Mathura ever?
Yes, sir, I have been.
What is special about Mathura?
Sir, there are a number of temples in Mathura dedicated to Lord Krishna. Sir, also there is a Vrindavan hill there which is called holy and people...
Vrindavan hill? Oh, the hill is something different. What is the name of the hill that is considered to be very sacred hill?
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware about
that
exactly.
Also not Vrindavan. Over there?
Yes, correct, sir. Sorry.
You know the folklore associated with Govardhan?
Sir, yes, I did read it, and Lord Krishna had to uplift it to protect his subjects from a flood.
Okay. You have studied computer engineering. These days, computer is being used or is likely to be used for bringing transparency in administration. What are the steps taken by the government in recent past to bring about transparency in administration?
So the government through the RTI Act has started digitalization of all the files which are there in government offices. And RTI as a act itself has been helpful in bringing transparency. Then government has been trying to start e-auctioning of all
what
the...
What is the setup for enforcing the provisions of RTI?
Sir, if a person files an RTI and he feels that his response has not been adequate.
No, what is the setup? You tell me right from lowest level.
So there are information commissioners.
Supposing you have to get some information from district magistrate. What is the setup there for ensuring that whatever information is asked for is given?
Sir, in my limited knowledge, what I know is that at every government department, there is a separate department and separate officer.
What is he known as?
Sir, I am not aware.
Information officer.
Right.
then what happens?
Sir, if the person still feels that his response has not been adequate, so he can move towards the Center Information Commissioner. He can file a complaint there.
Before that, is there any other provision?
Sir, at each state level, there are State Information Commissioners.
No, in the department, there is no remedy available from within the department?
Sir, I'm not aware.
You have to study about those important topics. What else has been done about bringing transparency in administration?
Sir, e-auction has been started for various resources to ensure that the auctions are objective as well as open for all. Sir, and then for transparency, the Prevention of Corruption Act, it has been amended to ensure that it becomes easier for...
What amendment has been made?
So the first amendment is that now that bribe giver is also under the provisions of the act and he can be punished for giving bribe. And then also...
Some people say that it's not right to do that because that will be a deterrent for making complaints. People will not come out for complaining against because they will also might be held guilty.
Right, sir, there may be some deterrent, but it's also important to make sure that the public is also held responsible. Bribe as such is both a giver and taker, both participate in equally, and both parties should be held equally responsible for it.
What should be done to, this is about punishment,
right,
but
sir,
what should be done to prevent such situation from arising in a department?
Sir, ethical training is one of the provisions which should be undertaken by all the departments to ensure that ethically they understand the responsibilities and the value system of all public officers are upheld. Sir, then the people who are caught in corruption, action should be taken against them.
I'm not talking of that. I'm talking before that, preventive. What you can say preventive action, what would be taken? One, you said that ethical education. What else?
Sir, whistleblowers should be given priority. They should be taken care of and it should be ensured that actions on whistleblowers...
What is the main reason for corruption in government departments? What do you think is the main reason?
Sir, India being a country which is still developing, so at some forms of governance, we are not very strong. And the people try to bypass that thing.
Why? Why people try to bypass?
Sir, they feel that through corruption, their work could jump the queue.
So that means there is something wrong in the system itself. If you think that, supposing I want something to be done, and if I feel that there are so many rules and regulations that it will be delayed, or there might be objections, so I pay money for that. So do you think the simplification of rules and regulations is not a necessary step should be taken?
Yes, sir. Certainly simplifying rules and regulations should be a step which should be taken.
In the last few days and months, a lot of things are happening in Afghanistan. Are you aware of that?
Yes, sir.
So what is the latest?
Sir, US has been talking with Taliban as such, and they have reached an agreement where Taliban has said to stop this, to cease fire,
mm-hmm.
And on the other hand, America will withdraw its forces.
So what will happen back to India?
Sir, India would be negatively affected if this pact is upheld because India has been backing an Afghan-led process. The Afghan elections, which were to be held 2 months after, they would be delayed or even cancelled. And also the influence of Pakistan, if Taliban becomes a legitimate power, would increase Afghanistan.
Is the Afghanistan president agreed or happy with the dialogue which is going on between US and Taliban?
No, sir. Afghanistan president is not happy with the dialogue which is going on because, firstly, he is not part of this dialogue which is going on, and also he feels that America is doing it for its own unilateral benefit and not taking in account Afghanistan benefit as well.
So, in the long term, if you are moving along with America in most of the international issues, so what will happen? this is the immediate neighbor where the, our stake is very high. So is it advisable for you, according to you, that we should go along with America in addressing other issues?
Sir, no, I don't think that we should go along with America in this issue. Because Afghanistan being a neighbor would be destabilized. America as such is not looking at this aspect. It is looking at the aspect of withdrawing its forces so that its expenditure and its military involvement in these countries can be reduced. On the other hand, the object of India's of India and Afghan relations are very different. India wants peace and stability in Afghanistan, mm-hmm. Which is not ensured if this process goes through.
Now, there are two channels of the drug trafficking. One is called Golden Triangle, another is called Golden Crescent. And India is the linchpin of the path. Recently, the Chief Minister of the Manipur has advised his citizen not to produce illicit crops. Now, looking at this backdrop, how do we see this in the coming years? One is Golden Crescent, another is Golden Triangle, both as almost touching upon the boundaries of India. So what would be your advice to disconnect and create a kind of atmosphere where the illicit India should not become the part of this whole?
Right. So firstly, we should strengthen our borders, both in Northeast as well as Northwest, to ensure that illegal drug trafficking which is happening is stopped. And also, India should take up initiatives locally with this population to tell them the ill effects of drugs, to tell them to morally the wrongs which is present in a drug.
So which are the main countries of the Golden Crescent?
So Iran, Afghanistan, Pakistan.
Very good. And Golden Triangle?
So it is in the south. East Asia, and the countries Laos, Vietnam, I'm not able to recall those countries.
In one of the meeting, it was Pandit Nehru was giving a lecture to the trainee IFS officer, and he asked very unique questions. Can you symbolize India with any particular animal? Again, I'm putting this question to you, and I will respond to you. What was the response of the major training IFS officer?
Sir, I feel India can be paralleled with a tiger.
That was the major response. Some called cheetah, but he said, no, it is not cheetah, it is not tiger, no lion, it was elephant.
Okay.
That's right.
Why
it is elephant?
Sir, on what I can understand, elephant is an animal which is very strong, but it is an animal which does not attack on its own. It only attacks when something is done against it. And also, elephant is strong, but it moves slowly, and it moves at its own pace.
Last question. There are different perspectives looking at the relation with China. And one of the perspectives which is less talked about is Indic perspective. Indic perspective is we are looking from the ancient history of India, and basically the interest what we need to propagate for our national interest. And according to that, the people-to-people contact with India, China, India and China were very good. It was elaborated by Hunsiang and Faiyan, the tribalists. There was not only two tribalists, there are many tribalists,
right,
which were not talked about. And they believed that India is Guru Bhumi. But over a period of time, in the last 60, 70 years under communist rule in China, they converted large section of the population as atheist. More than 68% of the Chinese population, they do not believe in God. But still, they are searching for, they're relocating themselves. So looking at this socio-structure of China, how do you see that could be cultivated in creating a better terms with China? Because other perspective, through the prisms of the West, which we have been, China is an enemy.
Sir, both India and China had civilizations which are very developed at that time. So we should look at from that prism, and also from the prism that Buddhism as a religion cultivated in India and was spread from India to these nations. So if we can connect on the spiritual level, the people of India and China.
Will it work with the current situations?
Sir, I feel...
Xi Jinping has given a new theory of communism. Are you aware of that? A new term has been given by...
Yes, sir. Mm. Sir, I'm aware that he added his own...
What is it?
Sir, I'm not able to recall the name, but he added it in the constitution of China. Sir, yes, I feel spirituality as a connecting factor is very strong.
Very strong.
And even if the central powers try to minimize it or to put it in the backbone, it is not possible. Mm-hmm. Spirituality will and should be able to connect both India and China.
So, do you advise and think that Indian governments to pursue this line?
Yes, sir, I do.
To reconnect with Chinese people?
Yes, sir. No, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Have you finished?
Yes, sir.
Abhinav, you must have followed the budget.
Right, sir.
So, what is good for the youth regarding employment? Is there any provision in the budget?
So, for the employment, firstly, the government has ensured that the...
Because, no, generally this minister was saying that everything is there for everybody, all would be benefited. So what is there for the youth?
Sir, majority of youth in India are working in the informal sector, and the budget provides for a pension scheme for those specific people, and that would create a security net for those people. And the insurance scheme starts at a very paltry amount of 55 rupees per month. So that would be very helpful. And also the government has extended benefits in the construction sector, and that is a major job giver industry in a country. So that would also create jobs.
You know, in foreign countries like US and Euro, they give the unemployment allowance, but that is very huge amount so that one can easily sustain. But with this meagre amount, is it, do you think it is sufficient to manage?
So the countries in the West, even if we compare the on the PPP level, it would be very comparable. And also I feel the financial, the India at this situation has a number of sector to look into. It has a number of sector where money has to be put. And looking at that, we can see that this is a very good scheme, and it would surely provide at least a net, safety net.
Okay. You are from Agra.
Right, sir.
And Agra is famous for Taj Mahal. Tell me why this has been included in the heritage site of UNESCO. And there are so many buildings. Why Taj Mahal?
Sir, I think for addition into the heritage site, they look into the cultural and historical significance of a monument. And looking at those, Taj Mahal, along with other monuments, even in Agra, have been included.
Don't you think this is the biggest mosque in the world, after the one that is in Abu Dhabi?
Sir, I'm not aware about that.
Shariat Mosque. Okay, after that it is the biggest.
Sure.
Anyway, you can. Now, government's smart city project is going on, and Agra is one of them. So, what are the criteria or areas where development will take place? Anything?
So the smart cities. Cover a number of areas such as solid waste treatment, water treatment, and also they look into IoT initiatives which can be taken up in various cities. So Agra as such has taken up many initiatives of sewage treatment and solid waste treatments.
But the first priority in this smart city, first priority area is infrastructure development.
Right.
Electricity, road, drinking water availability. So what is the present scenario? Because I keep on visiting Agra, that's why I'm asking you. Has the work is started or it is just has to be started?
Sir, yes, work has started in Agra on various various fields. Sir, if for one example, I recently read a news that a sewage water treatment plant under the smart city has been taken up, and also as far roads is concerned, I'm not very aware about the project.
Even there is no project regarding solid waste management. The city produces a lot of solid waste, so that can be converted into energy.
Right.
There is no project is going on. Maybe sewage treatment plant is there that I know, and water treatment plant. But there is no such approach, which is very, very important nowadays. And that's why the whole city is very dirty if you go into the old Agra areas.
Yes, sir.
Do you agree?
Right, I do, sir.
Okay. You have done your this BTEC from DTU.
Right, sir.
Computer science. Very good. Why tell us in the country that digitalization has been, you know, is a full swing. But generally the expert, they say that it has resulted in a job loss. What are your observations?
Sir, in my view, digitization has not led to job loss. It is very true that jobs in some sectors which are more manual and which were more labor oriented have been lost. But we have created more high paying jobs in areas of high pay and less danger.
Generally, I have seen in most of the offices where computers are being used on large scale, the staff is getting, you know, depleted day by day.
Sir, but along with Digital India, India has also started a program of Skill India, where government would ensure that the people who will lose their jobs in these areas will get skilled and will get jobs in better areas.
Okay, today there was a very important news regarding one natural disaster. Can you tell us which occurred in Bihar?
Sorry, sir, I haven't got the opportunity to read the newspaper today.
A train accident in Sonpur. Okay. No idea about that?
No, sir.
Another important question, last one. The RTI is nowadays getting the importance or significance day by day diluted. Why so?
Sir, in my view, I don't think the significance of RTI is getting diluted with times. Only I feel that RTI has become strengthened over the times. The government, all the government officers have started taking up RTI very seriously. There was some pushback towards RTI in the initial stages, but now they feel they have felt that it is their responsibility to provide information on the RTI.
But on the basis of RTI, nobody has taken any drastic action. There are so many cases. You just provide the information, that's all. But as far as action is concerned, it is not in the purview of that RTI Act.
Right, sir.
Okay, if you become the Chief Secretary of UP, you tell me two things what you will do for the woman upliftment.
So the first thing I would like to do in UP would be creating jobs for women. Currently, most of the women who are employed in UP are employed in agriculture sectors. And if they move to sectors such as textile or leather, it would be more paying, as well as they would get more chances to work. And secondly, I would look into law and order situation to ensure that women can freely come out of their homes and they can participate in all the activities.
Don't you think that adult education is very important? Because most of the women are illiterate. First, you have to educate them, at least up to some level,
right,
say high school level knowledge, and then after that, they can be trained in any way, whatever you want. Without education, they will not have, they all labor sort of thing, almost not even the metric.
Right, sir. Education is obviously very important to ensuring that the women in the long term get better jobs. So surely education should be one of the criteria.
Thank you.
Mr. Tyagi, you know that in Prayagraj nowadays, Kumbh is going on. And so what is your opinion about Kumbh? Why it is celebrated? And what is the significance of Kumbh?
Sir, Kumbh is one of the largest religious congruence which happens in the world. Sir, this myth that Lord Shiva dropped a few point, a few drops of liquid where the kumbh happens in India throughout, and that significance has after independence.
At how many places, you know?
Sir, Kumbh happens at four places.
Okay.
And after Kumbh can also be seen as a unifying factor for India, where people from all over the country come together as one and take part in the holy river.
Any significance from tourism point of view?
Sir, surely Kumbh puts UP on the map of tourism, at least locally as well as in the NRIs, in among the NRIs, sir, and with the with the governments trying to improve infrastructure in Kumbh, it would ensure that people from all walks of life would come to Kumbh. And if once they are in Kumbh, it would ensure that they would also like to visit other places in UP, such as being it Banaras or Mathura or Agra.
Okay. You tell me, today in the newspaper, it was there that yesterday was the coldest day of February in the last 5 years. And they are expecting the temperature will dip, you know, in coming few days more. What is this that, and the day before it was there that it is 18 years, you know, it was longest spell of cold wave, you know, for 48 days continuously when minimum temperature was above 6.5. What is the reason of this, you know, why it is happening?
Sir, the present cold which has engulfed India as well as many parts of North America is due to the polar vortex where the cold
polar vortex
sir these are winds which blow in the northern hemisphere in the upper portion of the northern hemisphere, and these winds have changed their position a little bit and they have started moving towards the lower latitudes of northern hemisphere.
Australia, there is another thing which is happening.
Yes, sir.
That is, there is a heat wave and temperature has gone up to 48 degrees Celsius. So what is this? You know, that, is it also a polar vortex?
Sorry, I am not aware about what is exactly happened in Australia. Uh-huh. But with the climate change, the scientist said that the extremities of the weather would increase. And it can be seen as one of the examples of climate change is happening around us.
So do you think that they are right? I mean, or needs further research, you know, to establish this fact that climate change is happening?
Sir, I do feel that they are right, but obviously the understanding which we have is not 100% concrete. We should continue doing more research in it because weather as such is a very complex thing which depends on a number of factors. So it is possible that we have come to know about two factors or a number of factors, but it is possible that even more number of factors are behind this.
No, but I heard that all climatic factors, you know, they are interlinked. It's not temperature. Temperature is linked with humidity, with the, you know, and humidity is linked with the rainfall. Rainfall is linked with, so it's all interlinked, is it not?
Right, sir, it is interlinked. Sir, but even if we see in an Indian monsoon, so the number of factors which we feel are important in Indian monsoon have been increasing through times. Every 5-10 years, the geologists find new factors which are responsible for Indian monsoon. It is because weather, it is very complex. So even if we have come to
the... What is the difference between weather and climate?
Weather is a short-term... Weather is short-term and for a local area, where the climate is seen over a long period of time.
What is microclimate?
Sorry, sir, I am not aware about microclimate.
Thank you.
Thank you.
In this form, there is a column regarding your home state or UT. You were born in Agra.
Right, sir.
And except that for education, you came to Delhi. Why is it that Delhi you...
I moved to Delhi after my 10th standard, and I've been here since then, except for 1 year, which I moved to Bangalore for work. So I feel that major development of my personality and what I am is due to this place.
I'm not sure whether UPSC will accept this or Government of India will accept this. Anyway, that's a different thing. Now, in your hobbies, you have mentioned reading books, watching sitcoms, cricket, football. What sitcom is what?
Sir, situational comedies, these are small TV programs around 28 minutes. Which
sitcoms you watch?
Sir, recently I've been watching a sitcom known as Parks and Recreation. And before that, sir, I've watched a sitcom called Seinfeld, Friends, Sara Bhai with Sara Bhai.
Have you heard of one comedy which was very popular at one time, BBC, by BBC. BBC, you know what it is?
Yes, sir. British Broadcast Corporation.
Broadcasting Corporation. So there was one which is very relevant to the field where you want to enter. You are aware of that comedy?
Yes, sir. I've heard about it. It's something on the lines of minister, Mr. Minister.
Yes, Minister.
Yes, Minister.
Yes,
right.
Yes, Prime Minister.
Yes, sir. Sir,
have you watched any of those comedies?
No, sir, it's in my list, and next I would, after completing this, I would want to watch that.
Okay, thank you. Will you please wait outside?
Thank you, sir.
We'll call you back in a few minutes.